Welcome back to How to Make a Gantt Chart in Excel, Part 3. If you haven't seen Parts 1 and 2, I've provided links in the description. In this video, I'll show how to create a stacked bar chart to view the entire project, and also how to change the display to weekly, monthly, and quarterly. This video covers some advanced Excel topics, and I cover a lot of stuff in a short amount of time, so be ready to pause and rewind as needed. The daily view of the Gantt chart is great for detail, but when your tasks are long, the scroll bar may not be sufficient for what you want. You can make the columns narrower, and then extend the chart area by copying the last column to the right. And you could use freeze panes to keep the left columns in place as you scroll. But when printing, you may need to print this across multiple pages to make it readable. So I'll go to Page Setup, click on the Sheet tab, and choose columns to repeat on the left of each page. Then go to the Page tab and change the scaling to fit to 3 pages wide. This works, but I'd rather see the entire project on a single page. So I'll undo this and show how to create a stacked bar chart to view the entire project. First, we need to insert a column that calculates the number of calendar days for each task. The formula is the end date minus the start date plus 1. To handle the error when the end date is a dash, we'll use the IFError function to return a 0. Now select the descriptions and hold down Control as you also select the start dates. Then go to Insert and select the stacked bar chart. Right-click on the labels and select Format Axis. Scroll down and select Categories in Reverse Order. Link the title to cell A1 by selecting the title, pressing equal, and then selecting A1 with the mouse. To fix the horizontal axis, I'll first change the number format to a standard date. Then go to Axis Options and set the major units to 30.4. This is about the closest I can get to monthly divisions in a bar chart. Then I'll set the minimum axis value to February 1st. Okay, now I need to add another series to the chart to show the duration of the tasks. Right-click on the chart and choose Select Data. Then click on Add. For the series name, choose the calendar days label, and for the values, select the range. I'll go ahead and update the name of the first series too. Now we need to hide the blue bars. Right-click on them and select Format Data Series. Then go to Fill and select No Fill. You can make the bars taller by decreasing the gap width. And I think I'll change the fill color to blue. Now we have a nice looking Gantt chart that shows the entire project. I'm going to move this down to the bottom for now and make a few other minor changes. To print just this chart, you can select it and press Ctrl P. I like this method of displaying the Gantt chart, except for how tricky it can be to adjust the horizontal axis. We could be done with the chart, but let's show the percent complete as a gray bar. To do that, we'll need to add 2 more columns. One will be days complete, and the other, the days left. For days complete, we use round down and multiply the progress by the calendar days. Days left is just the calendar days minus days done. Now we'll edit the chart. Right-click and choose Select Data, then Add. The new series we are adding is the Days Done column. We need to move this series up and then change Calendar Days to Days Left. Now we'll just fix the colors of the bars. Make the completed portion gray and the incomplete portion blue. The extra columns that we added can be hidden if you don't want to always see them, but the bars will disappear from the chart. To fix that, right-click and go to Select Data. Then click on Hidden and Empty Cells and check Show Data in Hidden Rows and Columns. The next thing I need to show is how to insert new rows. I'll add a new row by dragging this one down. I'll fix this weird display glitch by scrolling. If I click on the edge of the invisible bar, I can see that the chart doesn't include the new row, So I'll have to fix the chart by dragging the ranges down for all three of the chart series. These other two series reference hidden columns, but I can still see the edge of the range and drag it down. It would be extremely annoying to do this every time I want to add a row, so I'll show you what I do in most of my templates to avoid this problem. I'm just going to clear the last row referenced by my chart, shade it, and add a note that says insert rows above this line. Then to add a new row, I right click on that row and select insert, and then press Ctrl D to copy down from the previous row. Now the chart updates correctly without having to modify the ranges. For the second half of this video, I'll show how to set up an option to change the display to weekly, monthly, and quarterly. This will mostly be about modifying formulas. We'll first create this dropdown, and then modify the formulas of the date intervals, these labels, and all the conditional formatting rules. I'll first unhide row 4 by double-clicking on the row divider, then insert a row for the new display option. I'll copy these cells down to use their formatting, and then edit the label. The display options will be a dropdown using a data validation list. I'll type in the options separated by commas. It doesn't do anything yet, but the dropdown works. I'll cut this row to move it above the display week option. Display week won't always apply, so I'll change the label to display period. Also, I'll go to formulas, name manager, to change display week to display period. Then I'll name this cell display to help when referencing it in other formulas. This formula defines the first date in the display. We need to modify it for the monthly view to be the first of the month. So if display equals monthly, we'll use the date function and define the year, month, and day. We'll add the display period to the month number so that the scroll bar will work. Remember the commas and the closing parentheses. Now, the scroll bar moves the display a month at a time. The quarterly option is going to use another if function similar to the monthly one, so I'll copy and paste what we did for monthly and make a couple changes. I'll multiply the added months by 3 and change the first condition to quarterly. Now we have a wonderfully complicated nested if function. Okay, one more change. I want the first quarter to start with January, so I'll change the start month to 1. So the scroll bar changes between January, April, July, and October. Now we need to modify the date intervals using another nested if function. When I'm creating a complicated formula, I like to set up placeholder text, such as noting that for quarterly, I need to calculate plus 3 months. For monthly, I need plus 1 month, and weekly, plus 1 week. Then finish up by adding the 3 closing parentheses. This is obviously going to result in some errors for now, but that's fine. Now we'll update the formula, replacing plus 1 week with the previous date plus 7, then replace plus 1 month with the EDATE function to add 1 month, then again with quarterly by adding 3 months. Now we just copy that cell to the right. Let's update the conditional formatting rules that apply only to the daily option. First, I'll edit the rules for highlighting weekends, adding and display equals daily, the comma and closing parenthesis. And I'll repeat that for the crosshatch rule. It can be tricky to add the closing parenthesis. Using arrow keys or other keyboard shortcuts can mess things up. The last one I'll change is the rule that shades the bar based upon percent complete, because it's only accurate in the daily view. Now we'll change the formula in this row to show the quarter, month, or week number. When the display is quarterly, we'll show a queue concatenated with the quarter number, which we can get by using the choose function to return 1, 2, 3, or 4 based upon the month number. For monthly, we'll show the first letter of the month name. For weekly, we'll use the WEEKNUM function to display the week number 1 through 53. Add the 3 parentheses and then copy the cell to the right. The quarterly view now shows the quarter number. The monthly view shows the first letter of the month. And the weekly view shows the week number. Now we need to fix the rule that highlights the current date. If today was February 4th, I still want this week to be highlighted. And if I change to monthly, I want it to highlight February. Select the cell and go to conditional formatting. Edit the rule with a red border. There are 2 conditions, today is greater than or equal to the start of this period, and today is less than the next date. Now we'll do a quick check to make sure it works. Okay, last step. Fix the main format rule for the chart. Select the upper left cell, then go to conditional formatting to edit the rule. This cell should be highlighted if the task end is greater than or equal to the start of the period, and if the task start is less than the next period. It's important to realize the limitation of this approach, which is demonstrated by this second task, which looks like it may be 2 weeks long when it's actually only 2 days. If you switch to the daily view, you can see that it starts Friday and ends Monday. So the weekly, monthly, and quarterly views are better when you have long tasks. Otherwise, you can use the stacked bar chart method to view the entire project. That's it for this video. In part 4 of this series, I'll show how to set up color coding the bars of the Gantt chart. So make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications. Thanks for watching.